Hello, my name is Cody and I'm with LaunchDarkly. One of my favorite things about the LaunchDarkly platform is the ability to change the experience a user gets when connecting to your application based on things like their device type or the browser they're connecting from, or even what their username is. User targeting allows us to do this by creating rules around feature releases so that you can say if a user's connected from a mobile device, they're receiving a new component that you've developed specifically for mobile. Maybe you want to test out dev users with a new updated version of your application that's cutting edge, while your production users receive the same stable version they're used to, all from within the same environment. In this video, we're going to explore the concept of user targeting and build that into an application that I have. We're going to show how it changes based on the mobile device I'm using and applying specific flags to that configuration. It's going to be a lot of fun, so let's jump into it and take a look. Here's the application we've been working with in this video. You see it's showing up the same on my phone as on my desktop browser. We're used to this concept of popping into LaunchDarkly, hitting a feature flag like this updated header feature flag, and seeing how the application changes. Notice on both devices, I'm getting the same feature flag now, the updated header with a different tagline. This is an all or nothing approach. We've turned on a targeting rule and everybody connected to the application gets that feature. In this video, we want to talk about user targeting, so let's explore that a little bit. Let's go up to this users option and click on one of the users in the platform. Now in this example user I've set up, in this example configuration, I'm capturing three different attributes. One is a randomized key that's required at all times, and I've added two additional ones on. I've added a device type as well as an operating system type that are being captured within my application code. This user is coming in and getting browser type, and then on a Mac OS system. If it was a mobile device, I think they'd be getting a mobile type and potentially iOS as the operating system. Let's go in and turn on another feature flag and take another look at how this can change a little bit. So we're gonna go in and we're gonna turn on this logo image feature flag across both types of our application. So we'll do, again, another all or nothing approach. We'll turn in that, as well as turn on user login that gives us a logon component. So we'll switch back into our application and we can see I've got a logon field as well as having a logo now on the top of the screen. If I load this up on my device again, we can see, again, showing the same thing. Let's play with that targeting concept now around changing our image. So we have this logo version feature flag here that'll change the type of logo that's being displayed. Perhaps we want to show this only on mobile devices. We can come in here, we can add a rule and say device is one of, and we can choose that mobile type. This will automatically update with new tags as they come in and new capabilities as they come in. So if there was a third option, it would update this list with that one as well. I could also freeform and type in something here as well. In this case, I know there are only two types that we're capturing, mobile or browser. So I'm going to say mobile users receive this flag as true. I'm going to change the default rule to be set so that everybody else gets a false. I'm going to turn on this feature flag. I'm going to hold my device as I hit save. And we can see that changes to our friend toggle. If I switch over to the application on my desktop browser, we can see that I'm still getting the previous Osmo logo from LaunchDarkly. Now that was a flag based on the device or the browser type that was coming in. We can also do this based on the username that's coming in. So I have this logon field over here on the left-hand side. I'm gonna go back into my list of options and I'm gonna look at this release cards feature flag. I'm going to add a user-specific target to display this if Cody comes into the environment. And I'm going to change the default to false so that nobody else gets this flag. I'll turn this on, save the changes. And now if I switch back into the browser view, we can see nothing's changed. If I come in here and I type in John as a username, I've logged in as John, nothing's changed. But if I come in and type in Cody, I'm getting that new feature, that page, part of the page is loaded up. I'm getting this new release option here highlighted in purple. This is what we call a dark launch. So the idea of making a production change in your environment for only a subset of users. We're able to launch these features for specific users, specific configurations based on characteristics that are coming into the application. In this case, we're using the user targeting rules to change the experience between the devices. On my desktop, I'm getting the Osmo logo up top, I'm getting those release cards on the bottom, but on my mobile device, I'm getting just that toggle icon. Now, if I go back into LaunchDarkly, say I'm happy with the toggle logo, I wanna go ahead and roll it out to everybody. I can pop right back into that logo version feature flag. I can delete this rule and set the default to true. Now when I hit save and switch over to my application, we can see it very quickly switched over to the toggle option. There's additional options around doing these rollouts and user targeting. We could come into the default rule and switch it to a percentage rollout so we can gradually roll this out. This uses the key or some other identifier as the way that does that targeting. So I come in and say 50% of users are getting this based on browser type, based on device type, based on key. This lets us do that progressive rollout against a non-specific group of users. We can also create segments based on these same configurations. So I could say create a segment for dev users, save that segment and say, everyone who are in, add specific users or add a rule that says everyone whose key starts with the letter C becomes a part of this dev users group, and I can target off of that segment as well. We can bring these segments in from Amplitude, and those allow us to create larger groups of users, larger configurations of users that are going to receive specific feature flag configurations. User targeting is one of the best ways to create scale within your release process. We use this user targeting to roll out features to groups of users, test them out in production, and make sure that the users we want are getting the results we want before we roll out to our entire population. It lets us keep our blast radius small and gradually trickle out these changes. In the event of a problem, we can simply turn it off and that feature is removed from everybody inside of the platform. We can also choose specific users or specific groups to remove that feature from. We can choose specific users within that user list and apply specific configurations to them to test things out in a more case-by-case basis. Hope you enjoyed exploring user targeting with us. It's a feature I really love inside of the platform. Excited to hear more about how you're using it. Feel free to reach out anytime. Have a great day.